Hey guys, I'm sitting here in my office, bringing you guys to the CAD screen of where we've been designing the LJ chassis that we released about a week ago, 2 weeks ago, for sale right around Black Friday. But we're going to go in and kind of show you guys the whole thought process behind it and what all we've been doing to design it and where we spend a lot of time designing and what that's going to help the guys at home that want to try to buy the chassis and take it home and build it out. So, pretty much this is the first LJ we did. It's for a good customer of ours, Robbie. LJ, and then we did 14 bolts front and rear with bypasses and coilovers and everything. So, you can see we took the regular, pretty much our Jeep chassis frame. The front half is pretty much right what is underneath the TJs and the CJs. Back half, the tub on a LJ is 15 inches longer than the tub on the TJ and stuff, so we had to do some stuff to accommodate that, but pretty much there. So whenever you kind of look at this thing and roll it around on the screen here, I'm going to go into actually going ahead and we'll throw the front axles up underneath it, and then the rear axle links. And then we're looking for link mounts at the chassis. So this right here is drawn with 14 bolts front and rear. We can definitely provide those for people if they want them. If there's other axles out there that you want to put in it when you're building at home, you know, definitely would fit. We do like to see a one-ton full-size axle underneath this thing. So you can kind of see the geometry and stuff, but all the link mounts and stuff are built. We've got brackets, and we sell all the bracket kit. We sell them welded on, or you can just buy the kit. You can weld it on if you wanted to, but we sell them welded on, pretty good price. All the trusses now, we have all the trusses done, front and rear. So when we're looking at doing that, then we can scroll back down, and you know, this is a big thing that we've been doing this truss and stuff, but we've got it turned into CAD to where you can actually see that we've got a steering ram mount now for a PSC ram and the gussets and everything else that goes with it. So you can buy all this stuff from us. We'll send it to you. You can put it on at home. You know, kind of looking at this thing from the bottom side, we included the rear sway bar. It drills right into this bottom mount, comes out if you set the link mounts the right distance apart. It has that figured out for you now, or you can just straight out do that. We've designed a skid plate kit that we've been using in-house forever, but now we're actually going to put into a kit where you can buy the tabs. We'll give this to you with a layout of where we would put the tabs. And actually, you know, the plate and everything. The plate's going to come rough cut. You have to drill the holes. Everybody's going to put that tab in just a little bit of a different spot. May even make a video on how to transfer holes over from a tab to where you would drill at it. It's just a little quick tip. But we have really tried hard to put this together as a complete package. Going from the bottom forward, then we can put the drivetrain in. So we're looking at that. Now we got drivetrain mounts coming into it. So this is the LS engine, turbo 400, and an Atlas transfer case. Now when we mount this, we're going ahead and we're putting in the engine mounts, and the crossover tube will tack in because we don't know exactly what oil pan you'll run. We do want you to finish that up and weld it up at home, though. Unless we're building something turnkey, then of course we do it all. The turbo 400 mount will be welded in place. The rear cross member with the Atlas support ring, we tacked that on because there's so many different variations on the backside of an Atlas that it's pretty easy. It's just a simple weld up thing. So we leave that a little bit loose. That way we don't build anybody into a corner with that. But all those, the brackets, the tabs, everything else will come with it and everything else. So now you can kind of tell that we've got a good solid foundation right there. look up here, we can go start going to shock mounts. This is the drawing for the single shock mounts. And then we've actually went ahead and did everything for the bypass shock mounts as well on this thing. So that's kind of huge to know that you can buy the chassis, put your tub onto it, and actually go back and buy all the bypass mounts to get the performance of bypass shocks on something that you can do at home. And when I say that you can do it at home, pretty much means that, like, we have drawn in all the shocks, and then we went to the other step and actually drawn in the shock mounts that you're going to need for your axle side. So if you buy the chassis and then you buy our truss with the link tabs and then all the shock mount tabs and everything else, you've got everything at home to take and build this chassis out, and they just start stacking on top of each other. But if you'll use all of our stuff, it'll all come out right in the end. It's built around Radflow 14-inch 2.0 coilover and a 2.5-inch bypass is what it's built around. So there you can see that you've got these tabs and stuff where you're like, well, I'll get all these at home and it'll be just a random box of tabs. So how are we going to put all that together? That's where we've actually came in. And this right here is going to be kind of the stuff that while I have sat down here and really taken the time to do this, is we've been building buggies for a long time, but we haven't been building them on the computer screen like this until now. But it's the reason we're doing it now is I really want to try to help guys at home get the buggies built more fluidly. So you'll be getting pictures such as this whenever you order the kits and stuff, and then like you can see them broke out. And there you can see the break apart file. So you need to take that and get it looking like that with a few measurements and stuff like that. So I kind of got a good advantage on knowing what the guy at home needs because I know what my guys in the shop need. So the questions they're asking me, I'm going on and answering them. Generally, whenever I answer all those guys' questions, the guys at home can generally build these things too. There's a lot of talented guys at home building a lot of cool stuff, and we just want to help provide parts for them. So I've really taken a lot of time to go ahead and do all this homework for people, wanting you to use our product, but like knowing that whenever I sell you this product, it's a really cool and really good product. It's a rear shock mount for the bypass. Rear shock mount for the coilover. Pretty simple little tab. But so now that we've got all the shock mounts and stuff, we do sell all the bypass mounts already ready and done there. You've got pretty much, man, look at that. You've got a front axle, steering on it, links on it, shocks on it, sway bar. That's pretty much a nice roller. Then we'll look at the drive shaft stuff. Actually, if I can find it. So the rear drive shaft we drew in to make sure when we flexed it around, rear drive shaft clears the rear cross member fine. That's the front carrier bearing kit that we offer. So it goes in. We can give you a pretty good idea of how all that goes together now. Some guys have had stuff. We've actually made a video on it. Stuff has been really cool, really popular. So we can do that. But now we've got drive shafts, everything else. It's like ready to set the body on this thing pretty much whenever you're at home or whatever else. Alright, there's the body. It's ghosted in. I took just quick measurements. The shock mounts do not stick through the hoods. You could tell from Robbie's pictures that, you know, some of my drawing on my hood is not exactly perfect, but it is a good rough representation. From there, now we've got a cage. This cage is drawn around the four seats in it. I think that as of right now, as far as a production unit, this is the cage that we're going to offer. The only one, because of we don't really foresee many people coming to us wanting a, don't really see, foresee many people coming to us wanting a sport back look with a two-seat cage. If we have a lot of interest in that, that's what we'll end up going to. So, that right there, kind of just looking, man, that's a lot of my options turned on. I do have different fuel cells for already drawn for the back of this thing. Actually, they're not in place yet, but they're drawn. We'll have a fuel cell that goes behind the back seat, in between it and the tailgate, and that way you'll have lots of good storage and stuff, just like what we do for the TJs. But a lot of the drawing and stuff's not really correct on how much of the transfer case sticks through the floorboard and stuff. You'll kind of have to see that in real life, whatnot. But we spent a lot of time in front of the computer screen to be able to turn something into something that not only is designed right, it ends up square, it ends up right, but now we can actually go back and do some instructional stuff to really help the guys at home. So pretty much, let's make our way to the shop. Let's check out one of these builds that's going on. You can see where all this time right here has been spent. Let's go out here and see where some time's been spent in the shop to actually see a real one. So spent a little bit of time in my office in front of the CAD screen. Now you can come out here and kind of see what all that time was spent on. Because I'm not just painting up pretty pictures. I just wanted to do it to where we can show you. But like whenever you look down here, it's our truss. Front steering ram mount, the gussets and everything else, now that you can put a steering ram on there. All the link bars, all that stuff looks like what we needed to look like. The chassis you can see, which has been for a while, double tooth frame rail. But then what's really cool, what I really like, what we all really like, the LJ tub, the length in the back makes the overall stance and proportions out right. Bring the camera over here and let's really look. So what's cool is, check out, I know this is an aluminum tub from Aqualoo, but check out how the rear frame rails fit. It fits this way on a regular tub as well. Now what is cool about this aluminum tub, the extra high fender well, we didn't have to cut this out. On a factory tub, you do have to cut the top of your fender wells out. On this aluminum tub that was built to where you didn't, that's pretty cool. But everything drops down, you got the right clearance and everything else. This rear truss tucks all the way up to where it just barely misses the bottom of the tub. We're getting full travel, 14 inch travel shocks. We're getting full travel, no binding or anything else. It just makes for a really cool product, but we've really spent the time designing it to where everything fits out and it's all right. This is a two-seat cage. I said we weren't going to do one for production, but this guy wanted one, so we just pretty much built him on one off. I don't know that we're going to put that as far as an option, but if enough guys call about it, then that's what it is. The thing about the other cage, the family style cage, we really built it around fitting the factory top, the soft top. So up in here, you got the two bolts that actually fit the door surround. The double B pillar won't let the top pivot. This guy said he's making a custom top. He wanted that look. So Jason, grab this wheel. Let's raise it up. So right now we're building this thing as a good built roller. This one's odd. It's got a Coyote motor in it. The new Ford hotness. We had to stretch the front frame rails out a little bit, of course, because this thing is a dual overhead cam. It's pretty wide, but it all fit and it worked out. A lot of people ask us about this grill protection hoop and stuff. We can't really add it on anything and weld it to the frame because everybody uses a little bit different hood and grill setup. Even if a factory one, we can't really dig and weld it, but what we can do is bend this thing, kind of tack it in place, or ship it to you. That way you final fit it around your body after you get your tub on there squared up, then the hood goes on and squared up, then the grill goes on and squared up. Then you can put this on, square it up, and weld it. So, not a good way to really just factory jig that and say it all works, because I don't know a Jeep that hadn't been rode a little bit hard and put up wet. So, we got winch mounts. So, pretty much the overall of what I really want to do this video about is launching the LJ. It's been asked about for a long time. I've kind of been the one that has been like, I don't know if it's even worth putting in the effort to do it. But since we've done it, before we did it, everybody asked about it. That Jeep's got a lot of love. So And now that I've actually been around a few of them, I understand exactly why. The extra room in them is pretty awesome. The extra wheelbase you get with it, I really like it. I really love just the way that the overall tub and feel of it is. We kind of set this thing here back down. You can get that side profile from the hood there. You get over here and kind of see that whole side profile of how cool it is. You know, that's the whole fact about the LJ that makes it super cool. So we're building them, we're selling them. Call and order yours.